गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू रिवाइज योर वन टॉपिक दैट इज रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द फॉर्मल लैंग्वेज एंड ऑटोमाटा थ्योरी. दिस लेक्चर कंटेन्स रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन ओवरव्यू, रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन वर्सेज फाइनाइट ऑटोमाटा एंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन, TFA टू रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन, रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन टू नॉन डिटर्मिनिस्टिक ऑटोमाटा. ओके, so what is the regular expression? As we have already discussed in the class, that is regular expression can be converted into the finite automata and vice versa. Regular expression can be converted into the regular language and vice versa. Even the finite automata including DFA and NFA both can be converted into the regular language and vice versa. So all the regular expression, language and finite automata, all are convertible from each to another component. And the regular expression is basically a syntactical expression. Finite automata, we know it's a machine kind of thing which accepts some string and say whether it is accepted or not accepted by a machine. It depends on some situation. And the regular language is a formal language which expresses the regular expression. Now I'm going to the next slide, which where we can see the difference, the difference of the regular expression and the finite automata. So the finite automata are given and the regular expression is given. So if the regular expression is only A, so it can be said that there are two nodes are there. It's a starting node and it's a final node, and only A is being processed. And if it is AB, AB means A dot B. So first A is being processed, and from the next node B is being processed in a serial way. And if it is A or B means either A will be processed or B will be processed. So from the starting node, either A is being processed or B is being processed. And the last option is A star, that is A is starting from a node and comes to the same node. So a loop kind of thing. So this is the regular expression versus the finite automata. Now I'm going to the next slide. Here few characteristics of regular expression is given, that first, if the language E is this, so if it is a language, sorry, I have not mentioned it, the language of E is E. So if E is a regular expression and F is also a regular expression, then language of E plus F is language of E union language of F. Similarly, if it is language of E dot F, then language of E dot language of F. Okay, so these are some regular expression characteristic which we have already discussed earlier in the class. So what is the precedence of the word operator? So operator, for the operator we'll first focus on the loop kind of thing, that is asterisk sign. Then we will go for the concatenation, like 1.0 or 0.0. So this type of thing will take first. Then the last prior operator is the plus operator, which denotes that either one expression will be processed or another expression will be processed. So for example, first is 1 star. So 1 star is the highest priority component. So first we are taking 1 within a bracket and we are giving star, and then we are giving another bracket, and then we are taking this component with a concatenation with the 0 as given. Then 0, 1 star is given, are given with 1. So either this thing will be processed in the automata or 1 will be processed in the automata. So this is the less prior operator in the regular expression. Okay, in the next slide we will see one example which demonstrates you the conversion process of DFA to RE. DFA means deterministic finite automata to the regular expression. So we can see a deterministic automata over there. You can see it, one Q0, Q1 and Q2, three nodes are there, and one loop is given in the Q0 is 1. So it is denoted as 1 asterisk. So then 1 0 is there, So it is denoted at 0 only, and this 1 asterisk and 0 will come in the, within a concatenation sign. Then 0 star is coming, so 0 star will again come in with a concatenation sign. Then 1 is coming, again it will be added as a concatenation sign. And then 0, 1 means either 0 will be processed or 1 will be processed. So it is and it is within a asterisk sign, that means it is a loop, self loop. So either 0 or 1, so 0 plus 1, it will come with a plus operator, and then the whole thing will comes within a asterisk sign. Then this whole thing will come with a concatenation sign with the earlier expression. So the thing, the total expression will be 1 asterisk 0 0 asterisk 1 and then 0 plus 1 whole asterisk. So this is how we can convert one deterministic finite automata to the regular expression. In the next example, we can see the conversion from the regular expression to the non-deterministic finite automata. So here 0 plus 1 with asterisk sign is given, that means 0 or 1 will be processed with the loop itself, and then once 0 are coming, 0 is coming, then another 1 is coming with a concatenation sign, then again 0 plus 1 whole star is coming. So the thing is that we can segregate in this way. We can take the 0 plus 1 whole asterisk in the left hand side, then we can take 0 and then 1, then 0 plus 1 whole asterisk again. So what is happening with a 0 plus 1 whole asterisk? It will comes in a loop, and either it will process 0 or it will process 1. So we are writing one comma between 0 and 1, then we are processing 0 from q0 to q1, and then we are processing 1 from q1 to q2. Then we are again, we are processing the 0 plus 1, either 0 or 1 in a self loop, so with a asterisk sign. So in this example, it can be very easily given that how we can take a regular expression, how we can break them into a sub regular expression, and we can solve it in a very simple way. So student, if in your examination such expression come which is very complicated, you first try to break it into the sub regular expression and try to find out the solution. Do not jump on it, otherwise you will be in a problem. So this is the few example of two examples from DFA to regular expression and the regular expression to non-deterministic finite automata. I hope you all are revising your all the topics. I hope this video will again will help you to revise your topic on the regular expression. So the assignment I am giving is whether the following statements are true or false. So few regular expressions are given. What you have to do, you have to take a regular expression, you have to simplify it, and you have to compare it with the right hand side. Similarly, see the left hand side are given in a very complicated and a little bit complicated way. You take it, you convert it in a regular expression, simple regular version, or you draw the corresponding finite automata for that, and compare both of them, the right hand side with the left hand side, and write whether it is a true or not true. So I have given the assignment in the Google Classroom. Find it and submit your assignment by the time. Thank you so much for watching the video.